I am sharing a case of stricture urethra. During the COVID time, patient does not want buccal mucosal urethroplasty. Temporarily, optical internal urethrotomy is done. The role of the guide wire in a patient who has undergone the surgery previously, first if you pass a Terumo guide wire through the working element, it really makes the life easy. I am sharing the video. Even though this video is nothing great, it is for the juniors that don't casually attempt OIU without passing the guide wire. The advantage of Terumo guide wire is that it somehow negotiates into the longest route and goes into bladder. As the surgery going on here, I always feel that the distal part of the urethra has to be cut, clean cut, so that your 21 French goes easily into the strictured area. Don't try to cut directly the deeper areas. First normal area you cut, make it more than 21 French, then your scope easily will be going. Clean one cut will be helpful. This surgery anyway will not help the patient, so we should not damage more. Here if you see, the guide wire is going down. Here if the guide wire is not there, you might have cut above. And the second point is, there are two accessory tracts now you see. You might have easily gone in those two. Can you see here two, bottom two small holes are there, which were previous dilatation or previous OIU effects. So if you go your blade there, you will totally lose the track. Previously I shared one surgery where I lost the track. Then I could gain from passing guide wire from above through the SPC track. So simple guide wire passes in a long stricture with multiple beads with previous history of OIUs or dilatation is very, very dangerous. So already bladder is full with we have to do very fast, or else you put a needle suprapubically and empty so that the pressure in the bladder does not raise. Sometimes it can cause severe septicemia. Sharing in the interest of the juniors. Thank you.